This is the Hajj, the Muslim pilgrimage, and here are 7 things about it that you probably didn't know. The Kaaba is a huge stone structure that sits at the heart of the Grand Mosque. Pilgrims circle the Kaaba counterclockwise 7 times at both the beginning and the end of Hajj. It's a ritual called Tawaf. Pilgrims also typically travel back and forth between 2 hills called Safa and Marwa for also 7 times. It's not entirely clear why it's 7 specifically, but 7 is a prominent number associated with the divine in many religions, including Christianity and Judaism. The Hajj generally has very little to do with the Prophet Muhammad. It actually commemorates the life of another prophet, Ibrahim. Yes, Abraham, who's also a key figure in both Judaism and Christianity. He was the one who rebuilt the Kaaba with his son Ismail. We've heard a lot of debates in the West about Muslims' face veil or niqab. Well, one place where it's definitely not allowed is on the Hajj. Women are expected to cover their hair with headscarves similar to mine, but the face veil and burqa are not permitted in Hajj. The pilgrimage industry is Saudi Arabia's 2nd most important after oil and gas. The tourism sector contributes $22.6 billion to Saudi Arabia's economy, with Hajj providing nearly half of it. The Saudi authorities forbid taking photographs, whether with camera or a mobile phone, at some of the holy sites. Any violation of official instruction could lead to confiscation of your device. The idea is to make pilgrims focus entirely on their spiritual journey. The Hajj takes 5 days, and towards the end of it comes Eid al-Adha, or the Festival of Sacrifice. Muslims worldwide celebrate by slaughtering an animal, usually a sheep. This is another part of the ritual that relates to Prophet Ibrahim. It commemorates the willingness of Ibrahim to sacrifice his son Ismail as an act of obedience to God. Finally, performing a Hajj is considered a great accomplishment for Muslims. In some cultures, people even add the title in front of their names to signify their accomplishments, so they are Haji. The Hajj absolves Muslims of past sins, so before the Haji-to-be travels to Mecca, it's very common for people to ask their relatives, friends, and acquaintances to forgive them.